We are ready with one question, and this question is related with our second chapter, that is forms of organization. Here in this situation, one particular case study based question we are going to deal, and here we will see that what condition is given, and according to that we are trying to find out the solution. So rather than wasting more time, let us come to the question. Let's see here. The question is, Mrs. Ingo started a voluntary association of 10 people. So 10 people are there, and voluntary association, so 10 adult members are coming forward, at least 10, and they are forming an association. So we have to understand the key points over here. So what information we got? 10 people and voluntary association. Remember one thing, whenever you are dealing a case study based question, just point out the important information and then try to connect it with your knowledge about different things. Now see here, who are also consumers? So here the members are consumers. Now she collected the capital by selling the shares. So here what happened? Shares are being sold and to the members, and opened a retail shop so that they can eliminate middlemen and get the goods at lower price. So you see here the information which we have got, that a organization, a retail shop was opened, and for opening the retail shop, one association was formed which was voluntarily joined by 10 adult person. These people are consumers, and they are basically purchasing shares. So they are purchasing shares, the consumers are purchasing shares, and the organization is the one which is basically selling the shares. Okay, so here if you just combine all these information, you can see this is related with cooperative society, because we know that cooperative society needs at least consent of 10 adult person. They can come together, they can form an organization, and for forming the cooperative society, the capital is raised by issue of shares. Shares issue is possible in two cases, either in case of joint stock company or in case of cooperative society. So here obviously it is cooperative society only, because here voluntary association, one information, and second information is that they're selling the shares to the members only, not the public at all. So these informations we have to first understand, and then only we can come to conclusion. Now you see one more thing. We got one information that no doubt it is a cooperative society, but here the society is open for the consumers. You see here, consumers are the one, they are the members, and here the society is open to eliminate the middlemen, because middlemen are the one who really exploit the people. They take very high profit, they charge very high profit and sell the goods at high price to the customers. So no doubt it is a problem for the consumers. So what happened here? Mrs. Ingo, she has decided to open a retail shop, and for that she need the consent of 10 people, 10 consumers. They come forward, they are ready to invest the capital, and for investing the capital they have purchased the shares. So this cooperative society is basically consumers cooperative society, because consumers are the members, and society is established for the benefit of consumers only. So here if you see the question, state the type of organization mentioned in the above case. So here it is nothing but consumers cooperative society. Name of the society is consumers cooperative society, because consumers are the members, for their benefit only this society is open. And you know that this society, the cooperative society, serves only members. Actually the motive is service motive, not the profit earning. No doubt they are not only serving members, they are serving general public also, they are selling the goods to the public also. but the motive is different here. In other forms of organization, if you will study, in case of private sector, all the firms are having profit motive, but here cooperative society is only the exception one. Here the motive is service, not profit here. Okay, so this is the first question part. Second part, if you see here, state the different types of organizations. So if we are talking about other different types, so one we have seen right now, this is consumer cooperative society. Beside that, there are five other type of organizations also. One is consumer cooperative society, and except that there are more five. This is one. Okay, now come to another one. Let us write one by one that if you go here. So first we have seen consumers cooperative society, first one. Second one is producers cooperative society. First of all, in the society where consumers are the members, which is established for the benefit of the consumer, is consumer cooperative society. Secondly, the second type of society, as you can see right now here on the board, that is producers cooperative society. And from the name we can understand that this society is established for the benefit of the producers, that is the small producers who want the raw material at lower prices, but they are not having the bargaining power to purchase more and more things. They can purchase a lower quantity only, and as a result they have to pay the higher prices. And at the same time, the other things which they require for the production purpose is also not easily available for them. So for the benefit of the producers, this particular society is established, which is termed as producers cooperative society. This society actually supplies raw materials and other equipments which are required by the producers here. So this is the second type of producers cooperative society. First one is consumer and second one is producer. Third one is marketing cooperative society. Okay, now when we are talking about marketing cooperative society, this society is basically established for the marketing purpose, because what happens sometimes, the small producers can produce the goods, but exactly they do not have the knowledge how to communicate with the customers in the market, how to sell the goods in the market, how to reach to the customers. So marketing is no doubt a big problem for them. So this marketing cooperative society generally do the help to the producers. They purchase the things from the producers and then later on they sell the things in the market. That is, the marketing activities is basically conducted by the marketing cooperative society. Let us come to the next one, which one is termed as farmers cooperative societies. Farmers cooperative society. If you see the name here, farmers cooperative society, that means this society is established for the benefit of the farmers, because farmers also face a lot of problem when the question comes about the seeds and the fertilizers and other equipments which is required for the agriculture purpose. So this society is basically established for the benefit of the farmers. They provide all the necessary things which is required by the farmers, as well as it also helps in selling the final products of the farmers to the market, the crops whichever they have produced, for selling them also, this farmers cooperative society works. So this is our fourth type of cooperative society. Now come to the fifth one. This is credit cooperative society. This is credit cooperative society. Okay. Now, this credit cooperative society is established for those people who want loan at lower rate of Yes, because the thing is that most of the time when we go to the bank, they need a lot of collateral, they need a lot of securities, and rate of the loan is also high, especially if we take the money from the money lenders, they really charge very high prices. To safeguard ourselves from that, this particular society established for the members, this is known as Credit Cooperative Society. This society is lending the money at lower rate of interest. So this is the fifth one, and the last one is Housing Cooperative Society. Now, it is clear from the name that this is providing the housing facility. That means those people who want their own home, for them only this society is established. They are providing the plot at lower prices. They are also providing the flat, which is completely constructed, to the members at lower prices. Either the member can pay installment, they can pay at one time. So different options are there. And this society is basically established to help out the members who want their own houses. Because no doubt our house is our dream home and we want our own house. So for helping those people who want their own houses but they do not have enough money, for helping those, this cooperative society is established, which is termed as Housing Cooperative Society. So from this discussion you can see there are basically six types of cooperative society. First one condition was already given in the question, and from there we derived the first type was consumer cooperative society, except that others are producers, which is established for producers. Next one is marketing, which do the work of marketing. Next one is farmers, which help out the farmers in conducting the farming activity. Then credit, which provide the loan at lower rate of interest. And last but not least, housing, which actually give the housing facility to the members at low prices or installment. So this was the question and related discussion. Hope so the question is clear. Thank you so much.